Hi and welcome to my channel again. I'm continuing with the astrology series for the rising signs, and this one will be for Capricorn rising for the month of December, for the rest of the month that's left. And if whether or not you've seen the last 2 months of my videos, you've probably heard that the last month we had the eclipses of the solar and the lunar eclipse, and also now Mars is in retrograde, and we're going to be feeling the effects of Mars retrograde at least till February next year. So there's a lot of intense energies going around at the moment. Of course, with the eclipse energies, they are from 3 to 6 months either side of the actual eclipse as well. So we've got a bit going on. So anyway, I'm going to be looking into the astrology again. I'm going to be using the same decks. I was guided to pre-pull some of the cards. That's why it looks a little different now. I initially thought that it was probably to try and make the videos quicker, but I've been going bad at doing that, so I don't exactly know, but I'm just going with it. So anyway, the first four astrology decks and the numerology guidance cards have been the ones that have been pre-pulled. I haven't yet seen them myself. And then after we finish with that, I'll be actually shuffling some cards from the notes from the universe on abundance to see what my abundance messages you guys can get for this December. And then I'll finish it off with some messages from the guardian angels for you. We'll see what comes through with those. So let's get cracking and see what's come through. So we've got Pallas Athena. And I'll be looking into the book with this deck and another one further along. Uranus. Okay. Full moon. Yeah, well, we've got a full moon coming. I'm not sure by the time you see this whether the full moon might have already happened. Hygieia. That's an asteroid, so it's Pallas. Aquarius. Okay, where's Aquarius for you? Well, oh, that's your second house. Money, your house of money and self-worth. Well, that's what I call it. Mars. Well, yeah, Mars is a bit heavy hitting with the energy. I think Mars will be squaring the full moon actually too. We'll see what comes through anyway. Third house. What's your third house? That's Pisces then, isn't it? And Virgo, where's Virgo for you? That's ninth house, I think. Okay, so before we go any further with the rest of the cards, I'll grab the book like I do with this particular deck. So we'll look up the back for it's funny that I should open up to ninth house, which we just said was in Virgo. I might read that actually. Inner reading. As the house of knowledge, this card is letting you know it is the right time to look outside your comfort zone and explore new subjects. What have you always been interested in learning but were too afraid to explore because you didn't think it was appropriate? Yeah, Virgo. The Virgo sign's always worrying about what, you know, about other people. A book can transport you anywhere in the world. These days, even an app on your phone can teach you a new language. Stop putting off learning the things you want to know. Ninth house, it's the bigger picture, the broader, you know, travel and the higher learning, where the opposite is the Gemini energy of the third house, which is the early learning before you go off to college or university or whatever. Maybe you have a special skill or interesting viewpoint that can help others. knowledge isn't relegated to a single person or idea. We continuously take old ideas and build upon them until they work with where we are now as individuals and as societies. I knew there was a reason I opened up to that. Okay, so now we're looking for Pallas. Excuse me. Wow, that might be a thing too. Another reading, I got a bit choked up. And I think the throat chakra was wanting to be known. Anyway, that's why I'm saying that, because it might be a thing to look into if you work with your chakras. Okay, when Pallas Athena appears in your reading, it is time to make a plan. Weighing the pros and cons of a situation is going to help you in the long run. Yeah, weighing up things. That's Capricorn and Virgo both do that. The physical act of writing your ideas down brings them to life. This helps us look at the bigger picture. Didn't I say bigger picture a minute ago? Yeah. We often think just about our next step, but strategizing further down the line will help ensure our victory. Become a defender of your community. Aquarius energy. It's not in your 11th house, it's your second. Okay, what's in your 11th? Scorpio, I think. Sorry. Okay, Pallas is not a me energy, it is a we energy. Just like we have to look at the higher picture of a personal situation, we are also part of the bigger picture in society. Your friends and neighbours, that's Gemini energy. Third house, Gemini. But Gemini's not in your fourth house. Aries is in your fourth house. Where's Gemini? Well, that's sixth house, yeah. Virgo, yeah. Virgo energy, Virgo themes. I call it energy, but themes of it. Okay, bigger page. Your friends and neighbours may have ideas that can be utilised to benefit everybody. Wow, that's a good viewpoint. Uranus, okay, that's further back here. We've got a bit of reading this time around. And Hygieia reminds me of the Virgo sign as well, because that's about health and hygiene, but not just physical. It can be spiritual or community health and hygiene sort of thing as well. I'll read that as well, though, if my throat will be okay with it. Sorry. It is time to do the unexpected. Take a leap into the unknown with the arrival of Uranus. This card is all about rebellion. A little bit can be healthy, liberating even, but a lot can be devastating. The choice is yours and yours alone. Going against the grain in a world that wants us to conform just feels good sometimes. Approach solving a problem from a new angle. Sometimes taking a step back and observing a situation objectively gives you a fresh idea. Imagine if the world's greatest inventors gave up the first time their ideas didn't work, or when their peers called them crazy. We would be missing all of these amazing things that shaped our lives. What contribution can you make to history? Here we go again, to history. See? Uranus frees you of your limitations and preconceived ideas of what is possible. He is here to liberate you from the bonds of conformity, which is Capricorn, your rising sign, and Virgo. You know, where was Virgo again? Our ninth house, wasn't it? Yeah. Yeah. But we picked up on, where was sixth house? Oh, Gemini's sixth house. For you, where was? Okay, I'll keep going. I'm jumping ahead of myself. I think I'm getting a bit all over the place. I have my Mars and Mercury are conjunct. So this Mars retro is sort of a little bit playing havoc with me in that sense, because it's right conjunct my Mercury in my birth chart. Okay, so we're looking at Hygeia. The full moon, I think, well, I'll still read it, but I think it's mainly this full moon. So if you work with the moon cycles, this full moon might be a particularly good one to work with for you. Hygeia's appearance means it is time to do a spring cleaning of your mind, body and physical space. A change in attitude is necessary in regard to health and fitness. We can only run on empty for so long before we are struck down with an illness. If you've been dealing with health issues, Hygeia can symbolise your search for help. If holistic approaches haven't been working, then it might be time to look into traditional medicine and vice versa. Consult your health practitioners and see what solutions you can brainstorm together. Like all elements in astrology, she has the potential to go overboard and become a hypochondriac or cause us more harm than good. If you are struggling with something health-related, take a look at her placement in your chart to get a fresh viewpoint. Okay, Mars is not an asteroid, obviously. Where are you, Mars? In here. Here we go. I think that's reiterating the Mars retro right now as well. But we'll see what else comes through. It might just be where Mars and Uranus are in your chart. So take a look. We'll see if any aspects come through too. The appearance of Mars can mean you need to be more confident in a situation. If you've been sitting on the sidelines watching everyone else get things you want, now is the time to step up. We know that being overly pushy and combative is damaging, but being a spectator in your own life is just as bad. Put on a brave face, even if inside you are terrified. Strength comes in many different forms. Mars can also mean we are suffering from tunnel vision. Putting all your focus into one thing isn't healthy. Whether it is a romantic partner, your career, or a hobby, letting your other commitments fall by the wayside damages them in the long run. If you need a push to physically start something, the red planet can give you a boost of energy, but be sure to actually follow through on what you begin. See, with Mars retrograde, things might be frustrating and stopping and starting or completely stopping, and that can frustrate us quite a bit. But also, it's same as with any retrograde planet. We can't hide ourselves in a cave and wait for it all to pass. It's going to affect us anyway. So it's not that everything is going to not work. It's not that we still can't move ahead with some things. We just can't forge full pelt ahead, if that makes sense. It's kind of like Saturnian bringing it back. Well, Saturn rules is the ruler of Capricorn, so you probably have a bit of you're probably kind of used to the Saturnian way of taking things slowly and methodically, which it came through this anyway. Virgo and Capricorn particularly are methodical and cross the T's and dot the I's kind of thing. And having Mars retrograde, it just means we still can forge ahead, but we can't plow our way through ahead on things. So sometimes that in itself can be frustrating. And if we're already frustrated, that can also affect our communications in that sense, because if we go in with a frustrated attitude of other things, it's going to colour that in and make things that much more frustrating and build on each other kind of thing in a not so good way. So anyway, here we go with the full moon. You have reached full illumination with this phase, and everything you have been working towards reaches the climax. This is where you realize that the journey is only half over. What goes up must come down. The positive cannot survive without the negative. That is just a fact of life. The plant you grew will soon begin its decay and subsequent death, and this is okay. This is all part of its purpose. That's definitely Capricorn wanting to achieve. Seeing and acknowledging our faults is the best thing we can do for our development. While it can hurt when we see our shortcomings, acknowledging them takes away their power. Yeah. Clear it away at the full moon. Release at the full moon. I think this is what this is bringing to your attention. I think for now that's that. We'll pop that back away. And we'll keep going. What else has come through? Pluto. Pluto's the ruler of the ruling planet of Scorpio. And I think in older astrology, I think it co-rules another sign. I can't remember now. Anyway, so we've got Pluto. And look, it's the Phoenix rising. So there's also that you can look forward to whatever's going on. You're going to rise from the ashes from it anyway. Okay, this is the picture, and it says, your ability to transform, take a big leap forward and rebirth. And it's right near Uranus, which is personal power, because Uranus doesn't want to conform to anyone, you know, and you can't transform if you're always staying stagnant and not moving forward. You know what I mean? Pisces. That's ruled by Neptune. Neptune hasn't come through yet. This energy is wistful, endlessly loving, compassionate, and forgiving. It confuses and softens resolve. Pisces is, where is Pisces? Third house. Here we go with the Gemini energy. Oh, because it's third house. So it's Gemini things, or related things. The 12th house. Well, this is the Piscean energy, is the 12th house. The fears, self-sabotage, self-undoing. But it's also about spirituality and sort of nebulous thinking. This is the area of your life that is overwhelming. You yield to a greater cause or power. Okay, so 12th house is Sag, isn't it? Yeah, because you're Capricorn rising. 12th house is Sag. Okay, so we've got Leo. Expressive, creative, loving, playful, warm, overt, self-confident, flirtatious, glowing, bedazzling. Proud, trusting, excessive. This is fifth house themes. Leo the lover. And it's about self-empowerment. As well, and creativity. Leo, where would Leo be for you? Is that seventh? No, eighth. Eighth house with Pluto, Scorpio energy. Fifth house, Leo, which isn't Leo for you, it's Taurus. And here we have performance. Leo's the performer. entertainment, creativity, costume, play, love affairs, passion, pleasure, parties, children, humour, romance, disco ball. Okay. Oh, gee, there's throat things going on. Mars again. Okay. Something to do with Mars. Desire, impulses, courage, force, heat, strength, competition, workouts, excitement, thirst, impatience, anger, leadership, engine, potency, willpower, motor, sex drive. Okay, what else have we got? Aries, which is ruled by Mars. Aries is in your fourth house. So we got third house there as well, Gemini. Wasn't Gemini energy, Gemini themes. Wasn't that Pisces in third? Yeah, I think so. And Aries is your fourth Cancean themes, the home and family. And this is Mars energy, the wanting to get moving and going. We've got Virgo again. The Virgo sign wants to have be noticed in here. I don't think I read Aries, but it was sort of active, self-starting, daring, fierce, assertive, fiery, exhilarating, innocent. Because see, Aries is the first sign of the zodiac, so it's like with Mars, wants to, is pretty much Mars themes, you know, wanting to go forward, go for it, sort of thing. Sort of aggressive, but not aggressive isn't always a negative. Because you can move forward in an aggressive kind of way, but with Mars retro, you have to move forward in a more Capricornian, your rising sign, considered way. Virgo, the alchemist. So Virgo's come through a bit. Chiron, the wounded healer. This is about your past wounds, even back to childhood. So there might be a bit of an emphasis on getting that cleared. Libra's about romance and relationships. Did we get anything with Libra? Where's Libra? Libra's in your 10th house, which is Capricorn themes, the career, the idealist. Yeah, your career might be involving other people, like some sort of business relationships, because it's relationships of all kinds, Libra, and it can at times also be about law, legalities, as well as Sagittarius. They're the two signs that can cover that square. That's an aspect. And I think I mentioned that there was a square happening with the full moon, but I think from what I remember, Mars is actually conjunct the full moon. It's squaring with something else. Is it squaring with Uranus? What's it squaring with? Oh, I can't remember. But a square in a chart is literally, it'll be literally, if you get a quarter of the chart and move it wherever and line up the certain planets, then you'll see that, okay, they line up wherever. If it's lining up as a quarter like that, it's a square. And that can be like, well, it says challenge. It can be a challenge. And again, it's not necessarily a negative thing. But you know, sometimes in order for us to move forward, we have to go through some challenges to learn. Sagittarius. Now, where do we have that in the 12th house, didn't we? 12th house. So what have we got if we recap? We've got 5th house, 12th house, 3rd house, 3rd, 5th, 12th. Anything else I've missed? Mars, definitely. Yeah, because I'm pretty sure Mars is conjuncting the full moon, but I'm not sure. I think it actually might be Neptune that is doing having the square, not Uranus. But you do have Pisces in here as well, and your 12th house, which is Pisces, Neptunian. I call it energy, but themes, you know. Okay, so we'll move on with the next deck, and this one can have reversals. So we'll see what comes through. Capricorn, your rising sign. I'll have a bit of a read in the book for you though, see what it says. Square, semi-square. Here we go again, square. So the square is important for you guys. Tension, see, quincunx. Their aspects again. And it's upright, see, because if it's in upright position, that's actually good, because it's in the guidebook that it has, it's actually considered as the gift. But if there's anything in reverse, that's considered the challenge. But so far we've got gifts. Oh, we've got a challenge. Okay, trine sextile. That's usually a good aspect, but you've got it in challenge, so we'll see what the book says when we get into it a bit more. We've got a few cards here. 12th house in reverse. Okay, so you've got 12th house. How many times did 12th house come through? Sag is in your 12th house. So yes, the 12th house is specific. And Uranus twice as well. You might want to check where your natal, which means where in your own birth chart that Uranus might be in for you. Before we move on to the numerology cards, I'll jump into the guidebook, like I said, and we will start with the 10th Capricorn. Now, I don't know if you can see it, if it's in the camera. This is it here. And so we're reading the gift because it's upright. Wisdom grown over time and through mature experience is the gift of Capricorn, as is connection to the spiritual traditions and disciplines that offer a sound foundation for our evolution. Spiritual, Pisces, 12th house. Evolution, Pluto, 8th house. 8th house hasn't come through, but it's Scorpio, and Pluto governs the Scorpio sign and 8th house. Okay, so the next one was these aspects. Wow, okay, it opened immediately up to this. So this is a thing, definitely, because you've got the square card there as well. So let's see, it's upright. Don't be afraid, because it's upright. It should be easier than the challenge one. So, gift. Take this opportunity to build strength and learn to reconcile the conflicts within. Ah, didn't we have those themes earlier in the reading? When you can resolve internal conflicts, it is easier to resolve external ones. I think the Virgo sign will internalize things. I think Pisces can too, because they can be quite nebulous. Well, that's more a Cancerian thing. I think that sort of, and the Scorpio sort of holding the cards close to the chest kind of thing, not really, you know. And with the Cancerians, they will sort of hide in their shell kind of thing, rather than have to deal with any perceived conflict. Okay, so We're up to 52, which is trine sextile, and it is in the reverse position, so it is we'll be reading the challenge rather than the gift. Okay, the path of least resistance can be both delightful and limiting. Don't get stuck in a comfortable rut. Yeah, I think again, see, I can say I can say this because I've got a lot of Virgo in my chart, so I know how I can get stuck in a rut at my own expense kind of thing. And I think that that sort of trait can be Capricornian and Virgo. And you've got Virgo come through again twice as well. Where was Virgo again? Ninth house. Yeah, I think it was ninth house. Okay, 12th house. Yeah, make note of the houses as well and see where your Uranus is. Even though it hasn't come through, check where your Neptune, your natal Neptune is as well. That might be something too, because of the Pisces energy coming through and the 12th house sort of hitting. Okay, so we move on to card number 50, 12th house, and it's in reverse. Okay, I was just showing you the upright picture. Oh, you've probably got that by now. Okay, so we're reading the challenge. It can be hard to find a healthy place between feeling subsumed by a group, Aquarius community, and dwelling in stunted isolation. Here we go with the Virgo and the Capricorn, you know, Cancer and Scorpio holding back sort of, yeah. Hopefully I'm making sense. I really hope I'm making sense. The 12th house asks you to face your fears, which is going to heal you or heal some of your Chiron wounds. And again, I'm not in your face because every one of us have Chiron wounds that we're constantly needing to heal. So I don't know that there's anyone that can sort of jump up and go, hey, I'm completely healed of all my Chiron wounds. Isn't that great? No, we've always got something we need to work on, work through. So yeah, when no one's exempt. Okay, so then we've got Uranus, and that's upright, so that's a good thing actually. You've had it come through twice, plus it's the ruler of Aquarius. Okay, right, starting to see a bit of a connection with that now too. Okay, so we'll read the gift of Uranus. I don't know if you can see it there. Okay. Prepare for an evolutionary leap. Phoenix rising. Shocking circumstances can force you to engage gifts you didn't know you had. Spiritual gifts, 12th house Pisces. Didn't know you had, and help you transform. Phoenix rising. You are not those external attributes in transformation. You are not those external attributes in transformation. You will not dissolve. Right. A caterpillar is still internally the same creature once it becomes a butterfly. Yes. Exactly. So you've got some transformation going, spiritual transformation, I think it is. And I say with Hygieia, it's not necessarily, what is it called? It's not necessarily the physical, just the physical hygiene, spiritual hygiene it can be as well. And have a bit of that Leo fifth house creativity. As Mars has come through as well, and it seems also to be not necessarily a negative thing. There is a square, but as I said, I think this square thing is maybe with Neptune and the moon. this coming full moon, I think it is, because I'm pretty sure it's Mars is actually conjunct, very closely conjunct with the full moon. I think it's Neptune, but I can't remember. Sorry about that. I really should make notes of this so I can got to kind of go, oh yeah, it's this, but no. So anyway, let's see what numerology is. Creativity. Number three. And third house was Pisces. Third house is Gemini. Themes, early learning. Pisces is in your third house. And that's number three. Three, which is the number of, as well as creativity and third house things. It's also action and activity. Aries and Mars likes the action and activity, as long as you're considered about it, like you always are with being Capricorn. Capricorn and Virgos do 74, which comes to an 11, which is a master number of service. I think it is, yeah, because it's relationship Libra as well. Nature, so maybe getting back into nature a little bit, or yeah, going for a walk if you can, or whatever you can do to connect with nature, I think would be a good thing. Healing, 66. I always think all double numbers, even up to 99, are master numbers, and six is I think temporary opportunity, but it's doubled, so there's opportunity here. And maybe it's in a sense temporary, in that use the full moon as that this full moon, because it's going to be a temporary opportunity because of the full moon only being in a specific time frame. But that can then set things in motion that you want to happen and clear some of the Chiron wounds and give you empowerment to transform. Hopefully this is making sense. So we'll move on to get some abundance messages for you. Notes from the universe on abundance. What can the Capricorn risers look forward to in this month of December? The final. Well, that almost wanted to cut. Oh, wow. Okay, all of them. Okay. How many have we got here? We've got a few. Well, is that? I think it's upside down. Yep. Now they're the right way. They don't have reversals, so don't worry. Don't need to stress. Virgos can tend to stress. I know you're not a Virgo, but Virgo's been coming through for some reason. Okay, so this is the first picture. Waterfall and some rainbow clouds. I don't know if the camera's picking it up or if it's all fuzzy, but anyway. Have you wondered if, when you just close your eyes, take a few minutes and redirect your thinking, Virgo and Capricorn, the monsters might shrink, the grins might grow, and the floodgates might begin trembling again once you take that time. Try it, except when driving the universe. Okay, the next one we've got is some mountains. That's very earthy looking, because Virgo and Capricorn are both earth signs. Oh, sorry, I didn't show it. In case you can maybe pause it and read it yourself or whatever. What if we change the world? Wow, world, change the world. Didn't it say something like that in one of the cards? It said change the course of history or something, didn't it? Something's coming through for you guys. Just have to do your work and open the floodgates. What if we changed the word work to dance with life, and instead of viewing it as an alternative to finishing, and instead of viewing it as an alternative to fishing or a way of paying our dues, we saw it as a chance to meet a parade of new friends, discover our own untested potentials. Phoenix Rising wants to rise for you. And unpolished gifts. We talked about that with Pisces bringing out your gifts, spiritual and other gifts too. And open avenues for abundance to come pouring into our life. Yeah, I bet lottery sales would plummet. Start the parade, the universe. Sorry I get sidetracked because I sort of think, oh yeah, this relates to that and that relates to that. No, did it, did it. Okay. Again, sorry. I don't know if it's on my end, it looks fuzzy, so I don't know if you're seeing it clear or not. Here's what I ask folks who aspire to being fabulously rich. Couldn't you just pretend you're a multimillionaire? You know, right after you're done pretending you're not. It's all pretend, the universe. Wow. See, again, we're looking at changing your thinking so that it's in line with getting, you know, the Phoenix Rising, getting what you actually want achieved. You know, 10th house Capricorn is always about achievement. Isn't Libra in your 10th house? Yeah. And last but not least is, isn't it a hoot of all the people in all the world who truly get it, few actually give it to themselves? Ah, here we go with the Virgo and maybe Capricorn as well. Whatever it is you want, start. Give yourself compliments, praise, and presence. Give yourself time, permission, and love. Hugs, kisses, and smiles. Winks, laughs, and applause. And I will give you even more. Now, please, the universe. Yeah, see, so if you're treating yourself well, the universe is going to go, oh, wow, then they're feeling like they deserve good things because they're treating themselves well. So I'll give them, you know, the same back, if that makes sense. I mean, the universe doesn't work against us, but we kind of, by our own actions, or we can bring positive or negative in our thought process and how we treat ourselves. And this is why the idea of self-care is so important, because that's putting the energy out there to the universe, showing the universe this is how we treat ourselves, this is how we want to be treated, this is how we're treating other people. And so we get what back, what we put out, if that makes sense. It's all energy, and it goes back and forward, sort of thing. It keeps moving. Again, I hope I'm making sense. Anyway, let's see what the guardian angels want to say. What they want you to know, Capricorn Rises. What do the Capricorn Rising people need to know for this December? Okay, positive change. Look at that. Ah, that's too many. Those just fell. We'll be here all night otherwise. Okay, but we'll have the others though. We've got a few of them. I'm not sure what came for who first. I think it was these guys. And then it was these. Okay. Everything's... As I said, I've got a lot of Virgo in my chart. Everything's kind of messed up now. Okay, look at this one. First off the bat, self-criticism. Will your angels ask you to please be more compassionate toward yourself? Self-care. Observe the times when you have critical thoughts about you and make an effort to replace these negative thoughts with positive, loving ones. You are a wondrous being of light, even if at times you think you are less than perfect. Remember that God and divine perfection exist in all things. And we've got a prayer. I don't know if it's clear. Sorry, guys. Dear guardian angel, to you I pray. When I'm fearful, help me remember that only love is real. When I'm lost, help me find my way. When I'm confused, help me to regain clarity. When I feel lonely, help me to feel your loving presence. Where I perceive chaos, help me to see order. Thank you. Then we've got positive change. Yay. Don't know. I'm not sure if it's picking it up. Dare to be different. Aquarius, Uranus, what was your 11th house? Scorpio's 11th house, isn't it? We got the Pluto, Phoenix rising though, Scorpio's ruler. Dare to be different. When you are criticized, remember that you will never please everyone. Many brilliant and gifted individuals were not fully appreciated or understood in their own lifetime, yet it is often they who have sown the seeds of change. Here we go again, sow the seeds of change. You're still here, you know, so you can make change. You're still here and you can make big change in the world, and the world needs that. Surrender. Full moon, yeah, I think we're dealing with, I think this is reiterating, if you do work with the full moon, then you'll understand. If you don't, I highly recommend it. Surrender. Remain positive about the future of our planet, for all is part of humanity's evolution. There is a divine order to all the chaos which you perceive in our world. Chaos comes through again. Nothing will ever truly change until we learn to love and accept all as it is. Lovingly surrender your judgments and expectations and your life will magically transform. And see, that's a thing as well. We can be very self-critical. Having a lot of Virgo, I particularly like that. And I think Capricorns can too. I think we're both Capricorn and Virgo can conflict. Feelings which you have suppressed for a very long time are yearning to be acknowledged and expressed. You are torn between what you think is the right thing to do and what your heart wants. And this is the primary cause of stress in your life. We, your angels, urge you to follow your heart. Do what you love and what you do what you love, not what you think you should. Yeah, exactly. Heart of the Lion, Leo. I know you're not Leo. Leo's in your 8th house, Scorpio. Phoenix rising. Leo in the 8th house. Phoenix rising, Scorpio. Pluto's the ruler of Scorpio. Last but not least, hopefully this will still stay in the video and not cut out. Compassion. Dearest one, be compassionate toward yourself. Here we go again. Yeah. Surrender the self-criticism and fear that has you believing you need to improve in order to be worthy. You are perfect just as you are. The only thing that needs to change is your perception. There we go again. You will come to realize the jewel you are when you love and honor yourself as you are. Wow. Well, sorry, guys. You've been told, but I think that this is important for you to clear some of the Chiron wounds. Work with the full moon if you can, and surrender some things. Do the surrender work as it is, or you know, to clear that away, because you've got things that want to come through. The Phoenix wants to rise in you. And it's your time, my friends. It's your time to allow that Phoenix to come through and dare to be different, like the Aquarius Uranus energy wants you to be. Okay, well, hopefully this has all made sense and helped you guys. And I wish you all the best for December. And if you celebrate Christmas, Merry Christmas to you. And I hope you and your family and loved ones have a fantastic and wonderful time this season, and all the best, and until next time, bye for now.